Laundry Appliance Log 18-7-2018. It has been 7 months since last week's video, with every waking moment, and there have been a lot of them, spent trying to do the engine room of Rusty Bucket Bay. I've not slept in roughly 15 years, and I would say I've fallen victim to the engine room at least 17 billion times. Civilization has fallen down around me, all of humanity is gone, and all that remains is I, Grim Grindle, sitting here in front of my Nintendo 64 amongst the decaying ruins of humanity, trying to complete this ridiculous challenge. But Grim, you no doubt would cry if the harsh whip of time hadn't reduced you all to dust, leaving only me. Aren't you over-exaggerating by a little bit? To which I say, no. No, certainly not. The numbers I gave are all accurate, and it is your perspective of reality, not mine, that has become horribly warped by this god-awful engine room. But as I continuously try and continuously die, I can't help but find a saying often attributed to Albert Einstein is popping into my head. Said saying, which no doubt you've heard before, is that the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over again and expecting a different result. In actuality, Albert Einstein never really said this. In fact, it's a little known fact that Albert Einstein never actually said anything because he was a mute. The reason this fact is little known is I just made it up now, though that doesn't necessarily mean it's not true. But let's be honest, it's probably not true. If it were, it would be a major cosmic coincidence, but it being a false fact presented as truth somewhat keeps in theme with what we're talking about here. You see, even though it's likely that Albie never said it, and almost certainly he wasn't a mute, even if he had said it, it would still be, in this case, entirely wrong. And no, what I'm on about is not actual definition. I'm not looking here to clarify that, as far as the Oxford Dictionary is concerned, that what Albie supposedly said is not literally the dictionary definition of insanity. I'm saying that, simply outside of the scientific method of actually literally doing the exact same thing mathematically and expecting different results is pointless, outside of that very scientific interpretation of the wording, the sentiment is simply wrong. I say this because when we, mostly mortal beings, are trying to achieve a task, it may seem like we're doing the same thing over and over again, expecting a different result, namely, to succeed, but in reality, unlike mathematically or scientifically doing the same thing, 2 plus 2 equals 4 and always should, we are instead continuously changing and honing our approach to try to improve on what led to our failure to hopefully get a different result. You see, unlike the mathematical method or the scientific approach, we organics are not in actuality doing the literal same thing. We are continuously tweaking our approach both purposefully and also unavoidably, because us mostly organic beings have a thing called memory, both found within our muscles and especially in our grey matter for which we depend on our success, that can only be built through experience, which mainly is born from our failure. And it is indeed only through these experiences and through this repetition that we could logically expect to ever really achieve a different result. Indeed, I'm saying that not only is it not insane to do the same thing over and over and expect a different result, but instead to ever actually expect things to improve without actually reattempting our own challenges and striving to do better would be in itself an insane thing to hope for. This is what they mean when they say practice makes perfect, which in itself is in fact a truly misleading statement, as perfection is itself a desirable but wholly unwanted goal that should always be strived for, but never should be reached. I make this statement with no hint of negative connotations to it, as after all, it would be really disappointing if we could perfect everything we do. In fact, it would entirely suck the joy out of what we're doing and make doing it itself entirely pointless. After all, what's the point of playing a game you can't lose? Where's the excitement in gambling if you can only win? And who would bother partaking in a hobby that you're instantly good at? Yes, indeed, my friends, the sweet taste of victory is surely dusted by the confectionery sugar of potential failure. And so, next time you're lamenting that you simply can't win, I ask you to remind yourself that it would be far worse if you could simply not lose. And to illustrate this, I challenge you to play any game with God mode turned on and see how long it lasts before you find it entirely boring. It may be an old saying, but we've been talking about old sayings all video, so I might as well bring up another one, namely that it's not the destination but the journey, and this is indeed the case. There's a reason that there's not a single collector in this world that has collected every item that they wish to collect. Namely because once they do so, they cease to be collectors, but instead simply people who have a collection. And if what you truly enjoy is collecting, and you love the thrill of the hunt, there can be surely no worse fate than having nothing left to look for. Indeed, when the last buffalo went extinct, so too did the last buffalo hunter, which I believe strongly illustrates the point that there is no fate worse, except perhaps perhaps drowning in a sea of spiders than actually achieving perfection. And while I'm not sure I believe that perfection is ever truly achieved, we do sometimes come frighteningly close to a degree that it might as well be equated with it. So what does one do when they come so very close to achieving perfection? Well, I suppose you have to set your sights for new goals. The buffalo hunter has to get into ghost busting and the stamp collector has to take up baseball cards. I personally, now that I've perfected the engine room, intend to redirect my efforts to perfecting the rest of Rusty Bucket Bay. And I suppose I'm okay with that. While this challenge was fun while it lasted, in succeeding, I've received the desired sense of accomplishment and look forward to new challenges. Well, gosh darn it, I guess I'm going to have to do the engine room again. This is sending me entirely insane.